Now we will see the next chapter, system of particles and rotational motion. The first concept in this chapter is of center of mass. What is center of mass? If we look at the definition, it looks a very hypothetical point. It is, but it has too much practical evidence. Now question arises that why did I choose such a point? First see the definition. What is the definition of center of mass? For a given body or a system of bodies, it is a point at which entire mass of the body or system of a bodies is supposed to be concentrated. So what is the definition? For a given body or a system of bodies, at which the entire mass of a body or system of bodies is supposed to be concentrated. Is supposed to be concentrated. Now, what do actually I want to say in this? It means, look at your house. For entire house, you can choose a single point. That is called center of mass. And then you will say the entire mass of the house is concentrating here. Isn't it look funny? Is it? It may look funny, but it has too much practical meaning. Why such a point we want to bring, which appears to be very hypothetical point, or hypothetical point is supposed to be brought in the physics? Now see, in classical mechanics, all laws of physics, whether Newton's law of motion or law of conservation of kinetic energy, law of conservation of momentum, force acting on a body, these all formulae are meant for a single point mass. Single point mass means mass which has got almost no size, a point size mass. Now, in order to make all these applicable in the physics, it becomes very essential that we have to introduce a concept where a bulk size bodies can be reduced to a single point mass object. That's what actually center of mass does. That's how center of mass helps you to work out with your problems and explanation of problems day by day in classical mechanics. Day by day problems in classical mechanics. So, in case of centers, external forces acting on the system or bodies is applied at the center of mass, the state of rest or state of motion of the system remains unaffected. Let's check the center of mass of two particles. Center of mass of two particle system. Consider a system consists of two particles, M1 and M2 equals to masses of two particles. Right? R1 and R2 are position vectors of two particles. V1 and V2 are velocities of two particles. velocities of two particles F1 and F2 are external forces acting on two particles. Right? So you can look into the diagram. There are two particle system. M1 is here, M2 is here. Position vector of M1 is R1, position vector of M2 is R2, and in between there is a center of mass. Position vector of center of mass is RCM. Its velocity is V1 acted by a force F1. Its velocity is V2 acted by a force F2. Right, so total force acting on a system. Total force acting on a system. Total force F is equal to F1 plus F2 plus F12 plus F21. I can give it equation number 1, where F12 and F21 are internal forces, and their magnitude, these forces F12 is equal to minus F21. Therefore, total force is what? Force is equal to F1 plus F2. Now, for individual particle, we can apply law of momentum or Newton's laws of motion. So, F1 we can write it as dP1 over dt, that is dM1 V1 over dt for A. Similarly, F2 we can write dP2 over dt, then we can put it as dM2 V2 over dt for B, and we can also put for total force as d linear momentum of center of mass, that is equal to mass of center of mass, velocity of center of mass divided by dt, 4c. So, substituting all these values in equation number 3. Substitute these values in equation number 3 now. We will see what is happening. So, when we put it in equation number 3, we will get dPc1 PCM over dt is equal to dM1 V1 over dt plus dM2 V2 over dt. If I say momentum of center of mass, you can put it as dMCM VCM over dt, then it is dM1 V1 over dt, that is dM2 V2 over dt, integrating both the sides, what you will get? MCM VCM is equal to M1 M2 V2. This says law of conservation of linear momentum is very much applicable for the concept of the center of mass. That is, the sum of the linear momentum of two particles is equal to the linear momentum of center of mass. So the velocity of center of mass, if you want to find, it is M1 V1 M2 V2 over M1 plus M2. You can use this formula for finding velocity of center of mass, where M1 plus M2 is equal to total mass of the center of mass. Again, going back to the equation number 5. when we put equation number 5 again, see equation number 5, we know the formula that velocity is written as dr over dt. So we can write this again in terms of m1 plus m2 drcm over dt, or this we can put it as dm1 r1 over dt for the first particle, then second dm2 r2 over dt, integrating both the sides again, integrating both the sides, then what you will get, m1 plus m2 rcm is equal to m1 r1 m2 r2, that is movement of mass is also true for the center of mass. Total movement of the mass of particles is equal to the movement of mass of the center of mass. So from here you can get position vector of center of mass, provided if you know the position vectors of the constituent particles. So you can get position vector like this, right? For n number of particle system, n particle system, you can extend it. You can write RCM for n particle system as m1 r1 plus m2 r2 going up to mn rn divided by m1 plus m2 up till mn. Fine, that you can say sigma I is equal to 1 to n mi ri divided by sigma I is equal to 1 to n mi. So you have got an expression for n number of particle system. But you see, position vector of any particle can always be expressed in terms of coordinates. So we have seen position vector of the center of mass, we have calculated for two particle system, and then by symmetry we have worked out position vector for n particle system. Now we will try to find out the coordinates of the center of mass. So next article is coordinates of center of mass. What was position vector? Position vector for center of mass, RCM, I am writing for n number of particle system up till mn rn divided by m1 plus m2 plus mn. Now we know the we can easily represent each position vector in terms of coordinates. So we are writing vector r1 left is equal to x1 I cap, y1 j cap, z1 k cap, and vector r2 is equal to x2 I cap, y2 j cap, z2 k cap. Similarly, you can keep on writing for rn vector, you can say xn I cap, yn j cap, zn k cap. And for center of mass vector, rcm is equal to xcm I cap, ycm j cap, zcm k cap. Substitute all these values in equation number 1 and then check it out what happens. When you put up the values in equation number 1, so in the left hand side we will have xcm I cap, ycm j cap, zcm k cap is equal to m1 x1 I cap, y1 j cap, z1 k cap plus m2 x2 I cap, y2 j cap, z2 k cap plus mn xn I cap, yn j cap, zn k cap divided by m1 plus m2 plus mn. Now comparing the coefficients of the same, means I cap on coefficients of I cap this side with I cap in the left hand side. So xcm is equal to, you will get m1 x1, m2 x2, mn xn divided by m1 plus m2 plus mn. Generalize this term, I is equal to 1 to n mi xi divided by sigma, I is equal to 1 to n mi, that is x coordinate. Similarly you can find y coordinate, ycm, then it will be equal to sigma I is equal to 1 mi yi divided by sigma I is equal to 1 to n mi, this is equation number 5, and zcm is equal to sigma I is equal to 1 mi zi divided by sigma I is equal to 1 to n mi. That's how you can get the coordinates of center of mass also. For center of mass, let me tell you about special properties of the center of mass. So if we look at the center of mass analysis, that is position vector and coordinates of the center of mass, we can strongly conclude following points about center of mass. Number one, the position of center of mass is independent of the choice of the coordinate axis. I mean to say, wherever you want to coincide origin of coordinate axis, you can coincide, but the center of mass of the system or position coordinates of the center of mass remains constant. Constant means its position does not change. So first important point which we have concluded, that the position of center of mass is independent of the choice of coordinate system, right? So let's take an example in this to prove this. I give you a coordinates, this is one system, four identical masses are kept at the corners of the square. Each side of this square is A, and I coincide origin of coordinate axis here to this point D. Then coordinates of the point C is A indoor comma B, A comma A, 0, 0 comma A. Now find x coordinate, use formula m1 x1 m2 x2 till m4 x4, because there are only 4 particles, m1 plus m2 plus mn. So m is mass of each particle, so it is m into 0, m into a plus m into a plus m into 0 divided by 4m. So answer is a by 2. calculate YCM, that is same M1Y1 plus M2Y2, M3Y3 plus M4Y4 divided by M1 plus M2 plus M3 plus M4. Now this will be M into 0, M into A divided by 4M. So it comes out A/2 again. So x coordinates, the center of mass we have found as A/2, and y is also found A/2. So let us locate. A/2 means half of the side. So half of the side is this and this. That is the point where diagonals intersect. So where is the center of mass? A point where diagonal of the squares are intersecting. Now I am changing this position coordinates of center of mass. In same system I am not changing. And let us see whether there is any impact on the change in position of center of mass. Now I am putting up and coinciding 0 with intersection point, and these all masses are A, M, M and M. So side is A, coordinate of these points are A/2 and A/2. This side will be A/2 minus A/2. This mass will have coordinate minus A/2 comma minus A/2. This side coordinate will be A/2 comma minus A/2. Now use XCM and YCM same relation here. Then XCM will be equal to M into A/2 first, then M into A/2 second, then M into A/2. This is right, and then minus M into A/2. Right? This is minus, this minus, x minus, this is plus. So this is minus divided by 4m, so it is x is 0. Similarly, you can calculate YCM for this. M into minus A/2 plus M into A/2 plus M into A/2 minus M A/2 by 4M. So it is also 0. Now X and Y coordinates are 0, depicting the position of center of mass. So it is here. And which point is this? Again, where diagonals are intersecting. So when I coincide it, origin of coordinate axis with one of the corner of the square, center of mass lies at the point of intersection. When I coincide origin with the point of intersection, the center of mass lies at the same point. This shows that for a given system, the position of center of mass is independent of choice of coordinate system, right? Second important thing which we can conclude about the center of mass, that position of center of mass depends on the size and the shape of the body. That is the distribution of mass particles in a body. Of course it depends. So if you remove any amount of mass from the system, this will make difference in your center of mass. If you add any mass to the existing system, it will make difference in the position of center of mass. Other thing is very important, third point is that position of center of mass changes only and only in translatory motion. In fact, if you throw any bomb in air, and this bomb blasts in air and say breaks up into the fragments, but total mass remains equal to the mass of the bomb, then center of mass other particles after fraction after bomb is blasted, the other parts of the bomb may move in left, right and any direction, but the center of mass will always move along the parabolic path. Third thing is, the next thing is the center of mass process. Center of mass proves the laws of mechanics, because all laws of mechanics, as we know, are meant for single point mass, and the center of mass is a concept which reduces the bulk size of a body into a single point mass.